Welcome to part two of converting fractions to decimals. In this video, we'll take a look at converting fractions to decimals by performing long division. So there are really two main ways to convert fractions to decimals without a calculator. Number one is to convert the denominator to a power of 10 and then write the number using correct place value. This was covered in part one. And the second way covered in this video is to perform long division. Remember that a fraction bar is just a division symbol. So if we have a over b, that's the same as a divided by b, and we can write it in this form to perform long division. Let's go ahead and give it a try. So here we have 7 25ths. Again, this means 7 divided by 25. So if we want to perform long division, we'll set it up as 7 divided by 25. Now there aren't any 25s in 7, so remember what we can do is put a decimal point here, move it straight up into our quotient, and then we can start adding zeros. So now we can ask how many 25s are there in 70, and there's 2. 2 times 25 would be 50. Now we subtract, 70 minus 50 would be 20. Remember, as long as this difference is less than the divisor of 25, this digit up here is correct. And what we have to do is keep adding zeros until this decimal terminates, or until it repeats. So we'll add another zero here and bring it down. And now we have to ask, how many 25s are there in 200? Well, I know there are 4 25s in 100, so that means there would be 8 25s in 200. 8 times 25 would be 200. Now we subtract. Notice the difference is 0, therefore we're done. And this tells us that 7 25ths in decimal form is 0.28, or 28 hundredths. Let's go ahead and try another. Here we have 2 over 5, which means 2 divided by 5. So to perform long division, we'll have 2 divided by 5. Again, there aren't any 5s in 2, so we'll add a decimal point, move it up, and start adding zeros. And now we can ask, how many 5s are there in 20? There are 4 5s in 20. Notice the difference is 0, so we're done. And this tells us that 2 fifths is equivalent to 0.4, or 4 tenths. Let's go ahead and try another. Here we have 7 eighths, which again means 7 divided by 8. So in long division form, we'll have 7 divided by 8. There aren't any 8s in 7, so we add the decimal point, move it up, and we start adding zeros. How many 8s are there in 70? Well, I know 9 times 8 is 72. That's too many, so let's go with 8. 8 times 8 would be 64, and we subtract. 70 minus 64 would be 6. Again, notice 6 is less than 8, so this digit is correct. Add a zero and bring it down. How many 8s in 60? Well, 7 times 8 would be 56. And subtract. That would give us 4. Add another zero and bring it down. And now we ask, how many 8s are there in 40? Well, there's exactly 5 8s in 40. 40 minus 40 would be 0. So we're done. This tells us that 7 eighths is equivalent to 0.875, or 875 thousandths. And let's go ahead and try one more. Here we have 3 elevenths. Again, this means 3 divided by 11. We'll set this up in long division form. 3 divided by 11. There aren't any 11s in 3, so we add our decimal point, move it up, start adding zeros. How many 11s are there in 30? That would be 2. 2 times 11 is 22. We subtract. That would be 8. Add a zero and bring it down. How many 11s in 80? That would be 7. 7 times 11 is 77. Subtract. That would be 3. Add another zero and bring it down. Now we have 30. How many 11s in 30? Well, we asked that question earlier. That was 2. 2 times 11 is 22. Subtract. That would be 8. Add another 0 and bring it down. How many 11s in 80? Well, we just asked that question as well. That was 7. 7 times 11 is 77. Subtract. Difference is 3. Add another 0 and bring it all the way down. Notice we keep getting the same numbers here, and that's an indication that our digits are repeating. We take a look at our quotient. We have 0.2727. So this decimal is going to be 0.27 repeating. So we can say that 3/11 is equivalent to 0.27. And to show the 27 repeats, we put a bar over the 2 and the 7. Okay, that's going to do it for this video. I hope you found this helpful.